Yo, what's up, guys? Today, I'm going to show you how to fix the many free trials cursor error once and for all in 2025. But hold up. Before we start, you gotta hit that subscribe button. I don't know why, but everyone who skips this step ends up stuck with the same problem. Coincidence? I don't think so. Better safe than sorry, right? Alright, let's get into it. The cursor got an update since our last video, and now you can't create unlimited accounts on the new versions anymore. So, first, you gotta click the GitHub link in the description and the pinned comments. Next, we need to completely uninstall the cursor. But keep in mind, just uninstalling it through Windows won't remove all its files from your computer. That's why we're gonna do a full uninstallation to make sure it's gone for good. After that, we're gonna install the old version, where we can still bypass the app's restrictions. Let's do this. Scroll down and click on Solution. Uninstall cursor completely and reinstall. API key issue. Download geek.exe uninstaller free. Then, choose the .zip option, and once the download is complete, extract the .zip file on your computer. All files were scanned before this recording, so don't worry about viruses or anything like that. This GitHub repository is safe and already has 8.7K plus stars. After extracting the file, double-click the .exe file. This program will completely uninstall the cursor, removing all leftover files and folders that the cursor creates on your computer. Files that a regular uninstallation wouldn't delete. All right, now with the program open, look for the cursor application in the list. Once you find it, right-click on it, and then select Uninstall. Wait for the uninstallation to finish. After the first process is done, the program will scan for hidden cursor files and continue with the full removal. Alright, now you can click Close and move on to the next step. If you check, you'll see that the Cursor app has been completely uninstalled, right? Now let's go back to the GitHub repository and install the correct version of the app. Scroll back up to the Download Cursor v 0.44.11 section and click on Download from Cursor Official. Once again, we scanned all the files before posting this video, so there's nothing to worry about. Now, let's wait for the installation while we admire this beautiful emoji. Great! Now that we've installed the correct version of the cursor, let's move forward. Click through the blue buttons until you reach the login screen. Don't enter your email yet, because the issue probably isn't fixed just yet. Now, I'll show you how to get unlimited emails using temporary emails so you can keep creating new accounts. Click on Sign Up to start the registration process, and then go to the Temp Mail website, which I'll also leave in the description of this video. Use the temporary email to create your account and receive the verification code. If the cursor doesn't accept your email, like it happened to me, open the temp mail site in an incognito tab, and try again. All right, we've completed all the initial steps, and the good news is that we won't need to repeat them for future accounts. Now that we're logged in, you'll notice that if I try to send a message in the chat, it won't work. That's because we still need to do the final step, and this is the most important part. If you watched my first video, you'll remember that we only did this step before, and now we need to do it again. So, let's go back to the GitHub repository. Scroll to the one-click solution section and copy the Windows code. Now, with the code copied, go to your computer's search bar and type Windows PowerShell. Make sure to open PowerShell as an administrator. Many people in the last video had issues because they didn't run it with admin privileges. Once PowerShell is open, paste the code you copied from GitHub and hit enter. After that, you'll see some Chinese text appear, and I'll translate it for you. Do you want to disable the cursor's automatic update function? 0. No. Keep default settings. 1. Yes. Disable automatic updates. We're going to press 1 to prevent the cursor from updating automatically in the future. This way, we'll never have issues with our current version again. Next, just press Enter to close PowerShell. That's it. Now you can use your cursor without any interruptions. In the future, if you hit the limit again, just log out of your account, create a new one with a temporary email, and redo this final PowerShell step. Your cursor will be back to working perfectly. If this worked for you, drop a like on this video to support me and help me bring more tutorials for you. It costs nothing. Click it now. Go. 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 Hehe. Fire.